What up, what up, what up? This is your girl, Isis Wisdom of ElevatedRadio.fm on IG Live tonight. And I am going to be posting this on my YouTube channel as well. So, y'all should know me by now. There's some of y'all that should know me by now that's been following me for quite some time. And some of y'all should know me by now as far as how I move. And you know damn well I'm not going to make no announcement about going live on Instagram on Election Day. Y'all should know me better than that by now, okay? If y'all don't know me better than that by now, well, then you're going to learn me. You're going to learn today. You miss me? How y'all doing today? Vacation was great, man. As you can see, I'm glowing. You know, I had a good time on vacation. I had a really great time on vacation. I just feel so more relaxed and more centered and refreshed and rejuvenated. And I'm going to be doing things a lot differently as it pertains to my energy. Cause what I realized is I was giving too much of my energy out there and I work a lot. I work very, very hard and I think I'm set up pretty good now where I don't have to go so hard, but that's kind of like my motto, work hard, play later. But this vacation kind of gave me some insight about that as it pertains to my life and the direction that I wanted to go. And so I just wanted I need this vacation, you know, and I didn't really have any intentions of going live, but I know you guys are over here panicking. I'm hearing things, but I got to be honest with you. I'm still like in vacation mode, so I'm not tuning in to the stupid shit. Like I'm not tuned into anything right now. Because I just don't want to. I don't feel like it's necessary. And to be honest with you, there's a lot of people such as myself that's not really coming out and doing any lives right now. We're just kind of sitting back and playing a watcher game and just observing. And hope that we dropped enough jewels and gave you guys enough information that's leading up to this point. You know. So that's kind of like where I'm at with it. So, you know, I heard IG was smacking folks up off of lives left and right. I heard YouTube was shutting folks down today. So that was another reason why I didn't announce about me going live. So those who caught it, caught it. Those who didn't catch it will catch it after it's recorded. This will be on my YouTube as well as my Instagram. All right. So there's a lot of information that I'm still disseminating right now as far as the downloads are concerned. And I'm still receiving a lot of downloads from that vacation. Being away and not tapping into anything that I didn't need to tap to or staying away from a lot of distractions gave me the ability to receive some information that I probably should have received when I was here prior to leaving. But because I had so much going on, that's what it was. So I'm going to share a little bit of information with you guys. Now, as far as these elections are concerned, the first thing I want to say is that with everything that I've been schooling you guys about, you guys need to first remember who you are. Because when you look at the overall macro, the bigger picture, besides the mundane distractions that you see taking place before your eyes, remember this is about us. This is about the higher vibrational people. This is about the godhood. This is about us stepping into our godship. They know it. Everybody else knows it. Everybody knows their time is up. Everybody knows this already. So what I want to remind you is that you need to remember your place in the universe as it stands right now. You guys shouldn't be operating out of fear at this point. You guys already know that this is all a distraction. You guys already know what these distractions are designed to do. Even being concerned about the elections is even a farce to me when you look at the bigger picture of everything you see going on. So my suggestion to you all, continue to keep moving forward in your life. Remove away all the things that scare the crap out of you. Stop tuning in to those lower vibrational frequencies. A very simple thing to do. Okay. And start prepping for your own ascension. That's going to be a journey that only you can take alone. Okay? I'm working on my journey. My daughter's working on her journey. Everybody that are close to me is working on their journey. What are you guys doing? Are you working on your journey? Or are you concerned about everybody else at this point? I'm past the point now of wanting to save everybody. That I'm past that now. Okay? There are plenty of lives on YouTube, plenty of lives on my IG where people can go and read. You guys can even send people to the live so they can check them out if they want to get caught up and things like that. But I'm more along the lines of how to live. You know, Brother Panic put out a video called How to Die. You guys really need to go check out that video. He's got a 3-part lecture series, and I thought it was really dope. I got turned on to it right after I did my download when I was on vacation, when I talked about that the answers to the actual matrix construct is in the hieroglyphs. Someone had hit me up and put me onto his video because he had got a download 2 weeks prior to me speaking on it. And when I watched his video, I was really impressed with a lot of the information that he spoke on. Our brother's very, very knowledgeable, very, very educated. So you guys, when you get a chance, make sure you check out his video called How to Die. And basically what it talks about is what happens when you leave from here. What happens when you leave from here and where do you go when you leave from here? Very, very dope lecture series you guys should go check out. I'm more concerned about how to live because we're living right now. And so my focus is going to be about what we can do while we're living. How we can manifest our dreams. How we can make things happen for ourselves, especially now in this beautiful energy. Listen. It's so easy as for us to get caught up in the negativity of things, of life. But there is a way out of that simply by switching the channel in terms of what you decide that you're going to tune yourself into. That's what this is really all about. Are there things going out here right now? Yeah. Are there people acting crazy out there? Am I aware of it? Yes, I am. Am I focusing it? No, I'm not. Because I explained to you guys, with us being magnetic beings, that we are going to attract what we think about 99.9% of the time. You're broadcasting from your right and your left hemisphere. But because you're a magnetic being, you're attracting things to yourself, and that includes experiences. Whether it's the experience of poverty, if it's experience of anything majorly happening to you negative, whatever experiences that you have, whether it's experience of something major positive, you are attracting these things to you. Now, because of where the frequency is right now, you guys should not be concerned about anything fear related at all. What you guys should be focusing on is how to create your own heaven on earth. That's what you need to be at. I have made a point not to connect to a lot of different things that I just feel like I don't need to connect to, because what it does is it lowers the vibration. Let me tell y'all something. Got into the country. As soon as we crossed right into the United States, I can't make this up. A headache came. I got a headache. And I hadn't had a headache since this whole process, as we've been going through this whole essential process. I have not had a headache. When I was down in Jalisco, that is a very high vibrational area because you're surrounded by a lot of green, like a lot of natural green, like the ocean, the rivers. I mean, the rivers are spectacular. It's like they're so crystal clear and they're so beautiful. And the ocean is so crystal clear and it's so beautiful. And the trees were just so green and so vibrant. And when you're eating food down there, it's like organic food. Like when you get juice, if you want juice, they squeeze the juice right from the orange or whatever fruit that you want, and they give it to you like that, as opposed to I'm going to pull up something out from the refrigerator and give you that, you know. And I'm thinking about, damn, how we're living up here in America just ain't right. You know what I'm saying? It really makes you take a step back and look at the propaganda for what it is. One thing I'll say is that we did have a shift that did take place from October the 20th to the 27th. Now, everybody was concerned about, I want you guys to understand there's two different things that are happening here, okay? You had the shift that took place in the 7-day time period, and then you also have what we call the Carrington event, or the big solar flash that's going to hit sometime in December. Okay? That is when we're switching completely out into 5D consciousness. Okay? Does that mean that you physically won't be here? No, that's not what that means. That means that your consciousness is shifting to five-dimensional consciousness. That means that you're vibrating on the highest frequency there is, which is love. And to be honest with you, y'all, the where I'm at with it now, if that's not where y'all are, if that's not where people are at this point, I can't really rock with it. I can't really tune into it. Being down in Jalisco, I got a chance to see how the people operate. I've never been to a place where I didn't have to worry about my safety. There, I just never felt like I had to be concerned about my safety. Racism is pretty much non-existent down there from what I experienced. And just the vibration frequency there is extremely high. So I come into the United States, and the first thing I noticed was like an energy, like a heavy, kind of cloudy, foggyish kind of energy that came over me. And it really upset me. And I was like, why am I even experiencing this pressure headache? And why am I even experiencing this, right? And then it dawned on me that they're doing so much to try to lower the frequency. But not only that, it's the people. I'm picking up the vibration of the people and their mindsets and how much fear that so many people are operating in within this country. And the heaviness that I felt, that's what it was. Because for me, I was light and free. And I'm still enlightened free. So I had to do some things to protect myself to ward off that energy away from me so I could get back to my light and free self again and get rid of the headache. So upon entering into the US and experiencing that, it just made me get in tune with just exactly where the people's energy is. And so what I'm saying to you guys is that you guys have got to stop tapping into things that don't serve you no purpose, especially things that aren't directly affecting you. And I want you guys to really think about this for a minute. You can see something on the internet, you can see this, you can see that, but the real question you have to ask yourself is when you start going out here and you start panicking, is how much of that is actually directly affecting you? That's the exercise that I want you guys to start doing. How much of it is directly affecting you in your world as an individual, in your world, in your house, where you're at currently in the moment when you're present in the moment? I want you to think about that. I want you to really think about that. And if it's not directly affecting you, then this is how you begin to start changing your reality. This is how you begin to start creating positive experiences for yourself. When you recognize that, and you make a conscious decision not to like to tune into it. I'm not saying for you to turn your back to shit. I'm not saying for you not to be aware because you can always be aware. What I'm saying is that you got to know how to ingest that information into your system or not ingest it into your system. Some things you can just delete out your system or never allow to enter into your system at all because you know what it is and you know what it's designed to do. And what I'm realizing as well is that there's a lot of stuff that we're seeing that ain't even what we think it is that we're seeing. You got that game going on. And that is strictly to promote fear on a consistent basis. Okay? I'm seeing more situations where it appears that certain things are going on than it actually is that's really going on. And that is to incite a certain emotional response from us to take us out of our godhood. Put us back into the state of victimhood so we don't ever reach our godhood. See, the guys that are out here that are talking right now, they already know what time it is to see what it is. Y'all got to get to that point now where you guys see it for what it really is. Period. I want you guys to start working on some breathing techniques through your nose. I want you to take a look at the nose structure right here in this area. Have you noticed how it looks like a pyramid? I want you guys to start working on your breath. I want you guys to start getting into meditation more, especially during these times that we're currently living in right now. Why is it best to do that at this time? Because the energy is out here to activate the DNA to get you into your We call it mutant shit. Okay? I'm steady getting downloads. I'm steady getting communication. Something did open up for me when I was down in Mexico. And it's a constant, like, something is turned on constant. Something has been turned on down there. Now I'm just constantly getting bombarded with information. And so I don't want to do anything to mess up that connection that I have right now at the moment. But I'm going to tell y'all something. I saw some things. I saw some things flying around out there. and I don't want you guys thinking I'm crazy or anything like that. But I saw some things out there flying around. Now, I said to you guys after in my last live, I believe it was, I did on YouTube. Or was it Instagram? One of them two. Where I talked about how because we're transitioning to the fourth dimension that we would start seeing things that we're not used to seeing. And I'm trying to get your mind also prepped to know that you're going to be seeing these things on a consistent basis when the consciousness completely transitions into 3D. You guys are going to have to get your minds prepared for that. Okay, you're going to have to get your minds prepared for that. But I see some beings out here that are flying around. That's got some large-ass wings. Now, I don't know if any of y'all have been seeing it, but I've been seeing it as plain as day. Like, almost like standing there, and I'm like, wait a minute. Hold on, let me get my own bearings together. And they're indirectly showing up for me in a translucent form. So I want you guys to definitely keep your wits about you about some of the things that you might be seeing out here due to the fact that the dimensions are merging. All right. I want you guys to kind of get yourself together. You saw a fairy. You saw fairies in the sky. You saw Halloween night. Now the ships are going to start uncloaking this month. And I told you that was going to start happening. The ships are going to start uncloaking this month. So you guys need to be prepped for that. The ships are going to start uncloaking. So just get yourself together and get used to seeing it all the time. The Jetsons, all the time. Get used to seeing it. Oh, I see you, Spaz from away. I see you. Clouds are glitching and freezing. Two moons and two suns. That's what you've been dreaming about. All right, look. Someone made a comment and said that most of the Anunnaki are fallen too. What books are you reading, fam? And who wrote the book? It's important that when we start saying things, regurgitating things out of our mouth, that we actually begin to start doing some deeper research about that information. Because what I'm realizing is that there's a lot of information that was regurgitated to us that just simply isn't true. And there's a lot of there's a lot of lack of understanding that we have, especially when it comes to esoteric knowledge. If you was a part of the 1% and you wanted to scare people away from their stuff, what would be the easiest way to do it? The easiest way to do it is they would put stories out there to make it seem like things are way worse than what it is. Remember when I told you that everything you ever taught was in reverse. So now you even have to challenge even the information and the authors. When you get certain information, you have to challenge that. And I also go as far as even saying this. If you guys took the time out and stopped externalizing your power and you start seeking your answers, what you'll start realizing is the answers that you seek are already within you. The answers are already within you. All you had to do is learn how to quiet your mind and trust yourself. And trust the information that's being given to you. I don't care how many books were out here written. Okay? Remember, everybody that writes a book is only writing a book from their perspective and how they process information. And it doesn't necessarily mean that it's the end all be all. It just simply means that their version of the truth is a part of the whole version, is a part of or a piece of the macro version of the truth. Because everybody's going to give information according to their perspective based upon life experiences. It doesn't make them wrong. And this makes it the information that they're given part of their life experience that's also a part of the whole aspect of the truth. Okay? And I need you guys to understand that. It's a very important that you understand that. There was a lot of things about us that we were taught that was designed to make us think that we weren't shit. A lot of things were taught. And I'm here to dispel all of that information, all of that bullshit. So that way you can begin to start unwrapping your mind thinking that you're less than what you really are. What I'm here to do is show you how to activate your godhood. That's what I'm here to do. And show you how to activate your godhood. So when I give you certain assignments or I say to you the things that you need to do, such as shadow work, which will assist you in getting to the highest vibration, which is love. When you're in a God state of mind, one, you're not in fear. Two, you don't worry about anything. Three, you're always creating and you're always manifesting. You know innately when it's your time to do what you need to do. God's walking the know. Anything less than that, they're not operating in their Godship. All the people who are trapped in religion and all that, this life is not for you. If that's where you are, this life is not for you. I'm not looking to talk to the individuals who are trapped into that construct because we didn't got on past that. Okay, I'm looking to talk to the individuals whose minds are open enough to expand their mind as they should. There's a reason why you want to use 10% of your brain. The only reason why you use 10% of your brain is because you were trained from childhood to only use 10% of your brain. That affects us more than anything when you're always being suppressed or you're always being limited or you're always being forced into a particular way of thinking or a particular way of acting where you can't experience full self-expression because you have individuals out here that are scared to death of you and what that means for them. So I'm here to activate that and let you guys know that the only reason why you're only doing that is because of a program that you're operating in that you did not consent to. And no one ever told you that you could break out of that construct. No one ever told you that. Well, the queen is here to tell you that, babies. The goddess is here to talk to you about that. These little constructs that were put in place, racism that was put in place, that's a construct, okay? Poverty was put in place, that's a construct. Sickness was put in place, that's a construct, because most diseases are created in the mind. They'll tell you most diseases are created in the stomach, but in order for it to be created in the stomach, it first starts with the mind. Because whatever you're consuming that goes into your stomach, it didn't manifest out. Okay? So in my opinion, most diseases are created within the mind first. Based upon how you feel about yourself will determine how you care about yourself, how you look at yourself. Your mind is what determines that. Your mind is what determines whether you live an unlimited life or a limited life. Your mind is what determines whether or not you live in fear or you don't live in fear. Your mind is what determines whether or not you're going to be creative or not creative. Your mind is what controls the destiny of your life. If you give your power out to something that's external of you, you still don't get it yet. You still don't get it yet. We are in a time right now, at this moment, where the majority of the people here need to get on their grind in the sense of working on getting rid of all the things that limit them in their mind. Because see, here's what happens. You ever heard the term self-fulfilling prophecy? Self-fulfilling prophecy is when a person actually has a thought in their mind. And they believe in that thought so much, even though they try to fight it, that they actually create a chain of events for them to have the experience of their greatest fear, whatever that is. Not realizing that they themselves are the ones that caused that action to take place in their life. Nobody else caused them to take that. No one else caused that. They did, because they're not knowledgeable about the power that they carry within. You got a sun within your body. You got planets and stars and solar systems within your body. You are made from stardust. You think that they don't know that? Of course they know that. Let me explain something to y'all. Imagine this. What if your true self was a star projecting down here on planet Earth to have an experience? What if your true self was trapped somewhere else or placed someplace else to be bombarded with a lot of different things, distractions, so you couldn't get free to where you need to be at? What if? What was the sole purpose of why they created that station of Saturn on the moon so you could continue to keep reincarnating here on the Earth? What was the point to that? Who put that there? Who was it that wanted to enslave the population so we could continue to keep reincarnating and having these experiences, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera? Who was it that did that? What if you understood that you are so much greater even than the Earth itself? This is home for us. But what if you knew that you was an actual star and your destiny was to become greater than planet Earth and you were supposed to ascend way higher than what you are? What if? When I talk about how to live, what I'm saying to you guys is that you got to remove the limitation constructs out of your mind. You got to start doing exercises to delete those things out of your mind. And a lot of you, believe it or not, take on programs that have nothing to do with you. Some of you guys are living out programs and constructs that your parents lived. And in some kind of way, you took on the construct of your parents. And you're living in fear about living your life because you worried about what your mama went through or what your daddy then went through. Not realizing that that's their experience. That has nothing to do with you. Y'all will sit up here and have an argument with such, this, that, and third, and blah, 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 but that ain't got shit to do with you, and you never had the experience. But you'll limit yourself because of it, though, won't you? You'll sit right there, and you'll be so concerned about what somebody else went through and what somebody else's experience went through, not realizing that maybe it wasn't meant for them. Or maybe their mind wasn't open enough. Maybe they lack knowledge and education. It can be any number of things about why that person had that experience, but let's best believe this. They created that experience for themselves, whether or not you realize it or not. The real question is, what experience are you creating for yourself? And what the hell does their experience have to do with you? That's 90% of the reason why people are out here hurting financially. Did you know that? I do counseling. I do what you call money counseling, where I get to the root of when a person is struggling with their money and they're not able to manifest. When I get to the root of it, 9 times out of 10, when we go back in time, there was some trauma that they experienced they went through with their parents. Their parents saying, I don't have enough. We don't have enough. There's other things that they did that where they kept saying these things. And then next thing you know, the parents themselves didn't realize that they fell right into line with that construct and that way of thinking. And they created that for themselves. So next thing you know, the child picks up on that construct, takes that construct with them, and next thing you know, they're repeating the same things that the mothers and the fathers are saying. That's a curse. So when I say that when I come on board to consult people to help remove curses, that's no joke. Because a lot of times what you start realizing is once you recognize the pattern is that these are things that were taken on or constructs or belief systems that are outdated, that have nothing to do with where you are at this present time, at this present moment. Everybody that's currently watching this live right now should be out here manifesting their asses off. And don't get mad out here at the people who figured this shit out. What you should be doing is putting that information to yourself and working on how the hell you're going to manifest and get your shit up out of here. And if you got a mentality that you can't do this and you got a mentality that you can't do that, then guess what? You can't do it. And let me tell you something about that. You're not going to like this when I say this, but it's nobody else's fault but your own. Because of how you think. Because your lack of belief in yourself. Bump having belief in everybody else. Everybody else ain't got nothing to do with you in your journey. We all going to take L's. But we always get back up and we keep pressing forward. You learn from those L's. Now, some people are not learned from the L's. That's something completely different. And they might need to have some. They might need to talk to someone to figure out why they keep repeating these same patterns over and over and over again. But what I'm saying to you is that everybody else has the guide energy, the guide gene, the God spark within us all to be able to be released and do what we got to do. When I think about the solar flare that's coming, see, my process and how I look at that may be different than most people that look at it. I don't see this as something to fear. I see this as something, even from a symbolic perspective. From a symbolic perspective, I look at that like my whole being is now becoming ignited and activated. I'm looking forward to this event when it happens. I'm looking forward to it. Whether it knocks me off the face of the earth or it doesn't, I'm looking forward to it. There's nothing to be afraid of. When I think about the sun and understanding what the sun really is, Aten. It is so powerful and such a life giver, and we are the children of that. You begin to start realizing that there's no need for you to be in fear of anything. The download came to me. We always ran this shit. It's always been us. Regardless of what race came on the planet and started mimicking and mocking and doing all these things, it's still a program and it's still a construct. One that can easily be deleted and erased if the people could all get on the same accord and the same mindset. Do you know how easy it would be just to shut this whole shit down just upon how you think? That's how much power you have in your mind. That's how much power you have. And I'm saying power you have. Y'all are the powers that be. Because y'all don't even realize that it is the collective consciousness that's bringing all this stuff into play. That's how powerful you are as a human being and as a God. You are so powerful that you're bringing in these change of events. This isn't something that you're not in control of. You just don't realize that you're in control of it. You just don't realize that you're controlling the destiny of the entire planet because they got you operating from a state of victimhood. That got you operating from a state of I need to be saved. When do you start operating from the state of I'm going to do and there is nothing that needs to save me because I can save my damn self? Nobody out here is helpless, man. Nobody's out here a victim. Not really. For those of you that get me, that understand what I'm saying to you, that are operating on the same vibrational frequency as me, or you're getting there, that really feel where I'm coming from. If you guys feel what I'm saying to you, you get me. That's why none of this shit matters to me. I don't give a damn about this damn election. But you know that when you understand the corporate construct behind that, and you see the game for what it is, I'm not going to get involved in playing the game. The hell am I going to play the game for? What for? I go down a list of reasons why not to play that game, but you got individuals out there that are still stuck in that and believe in that matrix, because that is the matrix. Whether or not you guys realize it or not, it is a matrix. You have the power. Can you imagine if everybody on the planet came on one accord and started thinking on a collective level on the love frequency, how things could change? But yet, some of y'all let that stupid mundane things stop you from your greatness. Because you too worried about how much money this person over here making, how much success over here this person's getting, how come you don't have this, that, and the third, stuff that don't matter. And what you don't realize is that the people that are manifesting ain't paying no attention to you because they don't even know you exist. They're in their world manifesting and doing their thing. While you sitting up here being mad at somebody else's whatever they got going on, which makes no sense. Put that energy that you feel towards somebody else that causes jealousy and hate and envy in your soul and start applying it to yourself instead of waiting for someone to do something for you. Instead of thinking that somebody is supposed to save your ass. Because don't nobody owe you shit. Don't nobody got to do nothing for you. Now, humanity, from a humanity perspective, we're all going to look out for each other on a collective level. What I'm saying to you is that don't have the expectation of such. And learn to be a lot more grateful when you receive the help. Don't complain and speak down on your blessings whenever you receive the assistance. Don't dog out the people and turn on the people that try to help you and do good for you. Because every time you do that, you create a hell for yourself and you don't even realize that's what you're doing. You're too busy making 10 steps backwards being mad. But you don't realize that that person really is a part of you. So when you're mad at them, you're really mad at yourself. So when you come for them, really what's happening here, you're coming for yourself. And that's the part that people aren't getting. That's what y'all not getting. You put all that energy into being on one with another person. When you really take a step back and you really think about it, you're really on one with yourself. So, where does it benefit you at? Where does it benefit you at in your journey to ascend? Does any of those actions assist in your ascension in terms of where you're going? Maybe some of you guys don't believe in it. That's okay too. That's okay too. Like I said, everybody has their contract. Everybody has to live out their spiritual contract of why they came on the earth. Everybody got to do what they got to do. Thank you, Inner Bloom. I really appreciate you. And depending on others, depending on them, you know, the folks out here, man, let me tell y'all something. People out here are real weak-minded. I'm speaking for what it is. Folk out here just, their minds ain't right. You know what I'm saying? They don't have any constitution about themselves. You know, they get the help that they claim that they need, and then when they receive the help, then they take 10 steps backwards and then shit on the person that helped them, and then some kind of way mad because shit ain't going the way they need to go. Weird shit. People are weird out here. Or people don't know how to be there for another person. They don't know anything about loyalty. You know, I talk about loyalty a lot. And I read an old African proverb one day that says, loyalty is the path to sadness and disappointment. The only thing you can expect is duty. An old African proverb. In other words, don't go out here with the mindset that you think that people have to be loyal to you. It is your duty to do the things that you do to pass on the information or work or assist, what have you. You do that part, you move forward. Because people are going to disappoint you all the time. That's just life. I take life as it comes. I can't even be mad anymore at people anymore. I see past it now. I can't even be mad. Because once you realize what that is and really what that's coming from, and you realize that's a projection, you can't even be mad at the shit no more. People are going to destroy themselves with a mentality like that. You don't even have to do nothing to them. They'll do it to themselves. When you're on a path of being disloyal to people, you're on a path of being disloyal to yourself. If you don't trust people, that means you don't trust yourself. Very simple. And if you don't trust yourself, you're going to attract people around you that you can't trust. Did you know that? You're going to attract people around you that you can't trust. You got to trust yourself. Yes, rely on self and you don't have to worry about it. And I hope that for some of y'all who are nervous and stressed out about the elections and things like that, I hope that I was able to calm your nerves down, because I'm not with the radical or irrational, crazy, sporadic energy. That's the reason why I always set the tone on all of my lives to keep things on a certain level so you guys can really receive the messages that I'm giving to you guys today. Because this is all pure love energy right here, baby. And I'm not with the frantic stuff. I'm not with all the craziness. I'm not with it. So I wanted to kind of bring you to my frequency as to where I'm at and how I'm feeling, so you guys can really tap in. But I want you guys to understand who you are. I'm here to remind you of that, to remind you of who and what you are. If you don't know, then you just don't know. You know, I love everybody. And what I mean, and it don't matter what your color, your race is, what your religion is. I don't care about that. Because all those things are just constructs that human beings utilize to define who they are. At the end of the day, we're still part of the macro. We still come from source at the end of the day. You know what I'm saying? You may be this, you may be that. So who cares at this point? See, this is what happens when you raise your frequency to the God frequency. It doesn't matter. The difference is no longer matters anymore. Now, am I going to speak real truth about certain things? Yes, I am. Because certain things are scientifically proven. Does it mean that I hate? No, it does not. But I'm always going to speak facts. I'm always going to speak truth. And they are playing in the insane system. And they are. And see, those are people that haven't figured out the game yet. And if they didn't figure out the game, fam, they didn't figure out the game. The key thing here is that you stay out of the way of those individuals that didn't figure out the game. That's all you got. That's all y'all got to do. Y'all just stay the hell out of the way. You can see what's happening, but stay the hell out of the way. Because once y'all should know, y'all been around me long enough to know, and I've had a lot of you guys send me emails, send me DMs about how when you watch my lives, how things have changed for you for the better. That means that your vibrational frequency would have had to raise at some point. So once it raises at that point, then you got to say to yourself, when you see things, it should be damn near foreign to you. There are so many things I experienced prior to this vacation I took that when I went down there, whatever it was that I was experiencing is a non-factor now. It doesn't even matter anymore. I don't even care. I don't even care, fam. You know what I'm saying? Like, they tell you whenever you go over large bodies of water, because the Jalisco is surrounded by the ocean. So when you fly over a large body of water, whatever negative energies and things that you were dealing with at that time is removed. Flushed down the drain. Most people don't know that. Water, though, removes negative energy. Water does. Okay? Now, I wasn't in the ocean. Like, some of y'all was like, what are you doing in the ocean? I wasn't in the ocean. I was on the goddamn boat. And had a damn good time. But just that experience with Olokun, and feeling that energy and that power surge. I felt very safe and secure in that space. I just don't like the rocking of the boat. I don't like that. I don't like stuff rocking because I get sick. But I felt very secure in my elements of nature because I'm a nature child. I'm an Orisha priest. Orisha are forces of nature. So I feel very secure being in that space with them. That's why when I went down, I showed you pictures when I went to go see the reservation. The tribal reservation that I went to. And letting y'all see the shamans and how they do things and looking at their beautiful place where they are deep in the mountains. That shit's way up there in the mountains. And just being around nature and being tuned in to that energy was like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, this is what I need. Water is the ultimate healer. It's like when you're, for me, I'm going to speak on me. I can't speak for nobody else. But what I'll tell you is that when I'm around that ocean, something happens. I can't explain it to you, but when I'm around a large body of water like that, something happens and some shit opens up, man. And then I start getting this communication and things just come to me effortlessly. Something about the ocean, man. Something about that. You were glowing. Hey, I let me tell you something. My face cleared up. It's crazy. That made me realize how much stress I was under when I was here. I was under a lot of stress here, guys. Oh, my God. I was under so much stress. Yeah. And just to let y'all know, making y'all know right now, you will no longer be able to get access to me direct anymore. That's via telephone, via text. That's via email. You will not be able to get in touch with me anymore direct. I got people in place now that were responding back to emails for any customer service issues. We got a customer service thing that we're putting up on the site where if you have any issues about getting your oils or anything like that, you're going to send it and it's going to create a ticket. And then my reps will come in and take care of it and make sure you're straight. I won't be handling that no more. As far as spiritual consultations, I got an assistant that will be reaching out to those who I still got to do spiritual consultations for. That's my goddaughter. I'll be having her reach out to y'all. I will not be dealing with y'all direct until it's time for you to receive your actual consultation. She will be setting up an appointment and a schedule for me on that. You guys need to be aware of this. Oh, I'm changing the game all the way across the board. No access. And I got to do it that way and I got to set those boundaries because it was stressing me out. There's so many of y'all that follow me on Instagram, and I don't think you guys realize the amount of stress that's under when you got people putting demands on you 24 hours, 7 days a week. It's just stressful. Okay, so I had to restructure some things. So I'm working on my show, the Isis Wisdom Show, because I really want that platform to go to another level. And so I'm working on some things as far as the direction that I really want that thing to go. My lives here on Instagram are always going to be as raw as they need to be. That's not going to change. So that's why I started off on Instagram. That'll always be what that is. YouTube is something different. Okay? YouTube is something different. Because I really want to help people. I really want to do some things with people to really give them the information that they need. I'm going to be doing a free shadow work course that'll be on my YouTube. I'm not charging no money for this because I don't want to make no money off of nobody's pain. And I'm going to be sitting down working with a couple people, some professional psychologists. I'm going to get involved in this process. But there's going to be some things that I'm putting together where you guys can actually follow a particular program where you can begin to start working on yourself. Okay? And that's just a labor of love that I'm giving to you guys to help you guys. And anybody else that wants to really take the time out to go down the world of the shadow work so they can begin to start healing themselves. And then also there are people I can recommend you to that are professional that you can have one-on-one sessions with if you choose to. There's certain things you just can't get through on your own. There are certain life coaches and psychologists that I can put you in touch with that are conscious just like myself. So there's nothing that you can't talk about to us. You know what I'm saying? So I'm working on that as well. And I'll be working on that over a period of time, a program. So that's going to be some of the things I'm going to be working on. But I just want to let you know the construct is, the way I'm moving is about to change because it has to. okay? And I'm sorry I can't get to y'all in my DMs. You know, I just, I'm going to put a video up and just go down the whole thing so you guys can just see, like, the rows and rows and rows and rows of DMs. I'd be seeing y'all. He's like, check the DM. I sent you something. Check it for me. Okay, I got primary, and then I got those that are not in the primary that send me stuff. And those that are not in the primary, I check that maybe once a week. Just to see what y'all talking about that I bring y'all into my primary. Okay, you got the general box and you got the primary box. Okay? Don't take it personal if I'm not able to get to you. It's not on purpose. It's just I got thousands of DMs. And I do mean thousands of DMs. And it's hard for me to get through to some of you guys. Even the ones that are in my primary inbox, it's hard for me to get to some of you guys. So I'm going to ask you for your patience. And know that I love y'all. You guys can always ask me questions on my live. Some of you guys ask me questions on my comments, and I'll respond to some of your questions. You know what I'm saying? So if you say to me, check DM, I got a question real quick, don't ask me mundane questions. Like, I can't answer it. You know what I'm saying? If it's like that, just keep in mind I can't answer questions that you should be able to think for yourself and have answers to. Like, don't be asking me silly-ass questions. What someone asked me one day? They ask me some weird ass question, and I'm just like, does anybody use their brain anymore and ask and like really come up with their own answers? These are just questions that are just ridiculously asked. Like, it's just ridiculous. It's like, what? I'm not going to answer. If I don't respond to you and you see the scene and I don't respond to you, let me tell you what that is. That's either I saw what you had to say and I had to come back and get back to you, if it's viable enough for me to come back to you, or it's my way of saying to you, think for yourself. Okay? I told you guys there's going to come a time when you're going to have to start using your brain. That time is here. And it's going to get even stronger as time progresses up in December. You guys have got to start using your own mind and trust your mind, fam. You got to start doing this. Okay, not everybody's going to be around. All of us, the people that you see out here doing their thing, all of us also have our own journeys to live too. We got to get prepped too. We got families we got to take care of too. I need you to keep that in consideration. So you guys, start some study groups. You know, some of you guys start some groups off on Telegram. Y'all can start some groups on Instagram, start some groups on Facebook. You know what I'm saying? So forth and so on. But you guys have got to become more self-sufficient than what you have been. And you got to start trusting yourself. The information and knowledge is coming. But you guys got to start trusting yourself more when it comes to decisions that you need to make for yourself. Okay? Y'all need to start trusting yourself more. Your mind be having debates with yourself, girl, please. I do that all the time. You know, I be like, you know, one mind be over here saying, do this, and the other mind be over here, nah, don't do that, fam, because it is this, and this. And what I'll say to you is that, how do I calm that down? Go with the first thought. Go with your right mind. Go with what feels right for you. Even if you're off, oh, well. You did what you thought was best for you. And trust that until you get comfortable being in that space of trusting that aspect of yourself. Look, Butterfly says that she's got a group out of North Carolina to DM her. Yes, I need a group of pure conscious individuals. Thank you, Pi2T. All the thoughts we receive ain't ours. Boom! That's it. Because you do got spirits out here. Now, let me tell y'all something now. You're gonna see some things going on out here with the people, because some of these people, their minds aren't strong enough and are easily susceptible to certain types of spirits, where people can be coerced to doing certain things that they normally wouldn't do. And I'm going to tell y'all something. for y'all that think that can't happen, you're going to be the first ones to go. All right, y'all. I'm done. I got 5 seconds remaining. Peace and blessings to all of y'all.